Уважаемые коллеги, начинаем нашу пресс-конференцию по итогам матча ЦСКА-Цервена-Звезда. We start our press conference after ЦСКА-Цервена-Звезда game. And we have here the visiting team head coach Dejan Radonjić. Coach, please.
Congratulations to ЦСКА for the win. We were very soft in the beginning of the game. First 10 minutes they score 31 points, too much, of course, and they made advantage. After that it was better, but in the second quarter what was the problem for us, box out situation, they had a lot of rebounds, and second half was also better in that case, but they controlled the game and they deserved to win tonight.
Поздравляю ЦСКА с победой. Мы начали довольно мягко и в первые 10 минут пропустили 31 очко. Это слишком много. Мы позволили сопернику заработать преимущество. После этого мы играли лучше. Во второй четверти нашей проблемой было отсекать соперников от подбора. Это дало им возможность набирать очки со вторых шансов. Во второй половине мы и в этом смысле улучшили, но в целом ЦСКА контролировал ход матча и заслужил эту победу. Пожалуйста, если есть вопросы.
У Славяна осталось еще три встречи в рамках Евролиги.
Three games in Euroleague left. But we don't have chances for playoffs. What are your tasks for the rest of the regular season?
We will use all games to try to play best possible way to give our maximum. It is a EuroLeague competition. Always is, we have motivation to be on the court. Then we will play all three games with our maximum. Our schedule is too tough. Our schedule is too tough. Next 7 days we have again four games, but. Never mind, we will play all Euro games with our maximum.
Hvala puno, trener.
See you. Good luck.
Yeah. Where is Philip?
Ben said that he couldn't come today. and they say now we have a chance because he visited four games this season and we lost all four. You
know? Ah, so it's like
okay, you give us a chance.
Мы продолжаем нашу пресс-конференцию с главным тренером ЦСКА Димитрисом Итудисом. We continue our press conference with ЦСКА head coach Dimitris Itoudis. Coach, congratulations on this win and please your opinion about it.
Well, good evening. I would like to congratulate my players for the win. We were in control of the game. We opened it very strong. We had some lapses on defensive end, but overall we work a lot on how to defend the pick and roll and the isolation. Let's don't forget Lloyd is a great scorer. We kept him 9 points, and this is very important for us today. In general, we managed to slow them down, not to score over 80, which is their average on the last 5 points or the last five games. I'm sorry, EuroLeague five games, and overall we were in control of the game. So congratulations, keep going.
Поздравляю команду с победой. Мы контролировали ход матча. Мы сильно начали его сегодня. Да, у нас были некоторые провалы в защите, но мы говорили об этом в перерыве, и нам нужно было улучшить защиту и против пик-н-ролла, и против изоляции. Тем не менее, если вы посмотрите, сегодня Ллойд, их лучший снайпер, набрал всего 9 очков. Это говорит о том, что мы справились с ним в защите, и мы заставили Цервену Звезду набрать меньше 80 очков, а это их средние показатели в последних 5 матчах Евролиги. Пожалуйста, если есть вопросы. Давай.
Спасибо.
Для ЦСКА победа над Цервеной стала уже четвертой подряд. И ЦСКА наконец выходит из этого небольшого кризиса, который у него есть в январе, где у команды началась черная полоса, было много поражений, за счет чего у команды получилось выйти из этого кризиса.
It's a fourth win in a row after a kind of a crisis that we had in January. What is the reason for you to this improvement, let's say, that we went on four victories in a row?
We score more baskets and we receive less.
Thank you.
But in general, this is a long story about what is the crisis we got. I don't see any team losing four very important players on injuries. And getting into the process of bring them back, bring new players. And evidently the team was disconnected. We need to compose all these things. We need to come together and we need to play together. Definitely we did not have that much of a practices to get to know each other. And the players are not robots. When you come from the injury, you need a certain amount of time to readjust and to start getting where you were supposed to be. For instance, one of those cases is Will and Toko, that they can be robots. You bring them from the injury, you put them in, and they play. Phew. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for your question.